Sdk here. Today I'm going to show you how to set up Android SDK on Mac. This is like step 0 which we had done for iOS. It's like step 0 for Android. First thing, download the SDK bundle. Click on it, it will get downloaded. I've already done it. Then go to the folder where it was downloaded. Extract it. It comes with a bundle of Android SDK plus Eclipse. For now, I won't need Eclipse, so let me directly go to SDK. And there are two main executables. One is Android, and the other one is ADB. So if you go into this folder, and if you go to this path where you have ADB, so pull this here. ADB devices will show if there are at least any devices attached. So in my case, there are no devices attached, so it's not showing anything. So, and another thing is, if you go to tools, you'll find executable for Android. Run that as well. No. Okay. This will open the Android SDK Manager, from where you can install different levels, API levels required for Android. Let's say I want to install API level 17. To click on it, expand. Okay, make sure everything selected. We might not need this Google APIs and Mix Image, but usually I tend to install all of them. Click on install. Accept. Okay, sorry. Install. So now it will download API level 17 of Android API. The other important part of this SDK is Android virtual devices. These are some old virtual devices such which I had created, so we don't use them now. So delete them. So once API level 17 is downloaded, I can create a new virtual device. For now, I have API level 18. I'll just create a device with sample device to show how to do that. Yeah, 4.3. Use this option if you want your Android virtual device to use your system's host GPU, so that it will be much quicker than the default one. Snapshot feature is like, it's a feature in Android where the device will save the state where it was before, so the next time you launch the device emulator, it will be much quicker from. Okay, but can't be done at once. Say okay. And start your. Okay, before you start, if you don't select this, sometimes the resolution may be too big and it might go out of your screen. So select this and set the DPI to 150. It's saying how much it scale, like scale to 0.5, almost 0.47% of the actual size. Launch it. Installing this, there are a few path variables that have to be set, and the Android home variable, which is the most important one for running any Android commands. So should be set like this. This is the path where the Android adt bundle is present, and path to SDK, and then path to platform tools and tools. This should be added into path variable. This is the same command on Mac and Linux. For Windows, you need to add them into environment variables. Export Android underscore home. This will set the Android underscore home variable to the SDK path. So take all these three and copy it onto your .cache profile. Go into this folder and paste these three lines, and the setup should be fine. Now go to terminal, check whether the commands are working. Type in Android. Let's open a new terminal. The old terminal might not have my bash profile loaded because I've done it just now. Open a new terminal. Click on Android. Yes, it did launch the Android SDK manager. So let's close that. Next is I need to check if my ADB is working. ADB devices. Yes, I can see my ADB devices. There's one emulator running. 5554 is a port number. This is my Android emulator. It's running the latest Android version 4.3. So if you've done this much setting, and then you should be up and running with the Android Mac SDK setup. The next part is getting onto how install Calabash Android and writing the sample feature files. Thanks for watching my video. If you like my video, please do like on YouTube, comment and subscribe to my channel. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.